So welcome. I'm going to tell you what I think is the best way to start your journey in game development. Let's get started. The first thing is to pick an engine, and it really doesn't matter which one. If I were to recommend one, I'd go with one of the big two, Unreal Engine or Unity. I know Godot is popular right now, but I don't know anything about it. What to understand about picking an engine is it doesn't matter. It's just another tool to speed up the process. Do a little research, and I mean a little. Don't spend too much time on this. Basically, just to see the capabilities of each engine. Both Unity and Unreal can do 2D and 3D, but not all game engines can. Do enough research to determine if the engine will fit your game type. When it comes to high-end graphics, it doesn't really matter what engine you choose. Most likely, as a solo dev, you won't be pushing the engine to its limits. I would stay away from creating your own engine to start. Once you get more experience down the line, you can look into this. But I believe too much technical research and study will only discourage you and make you more likely to quit. So number two, don't start with small projects that don't mean anything. This can lead to loss of motivation and direction. I know this goes against everyone's recommendation, but I think those recommendations are wrong. I call this tutorial limbo. I found myself in this before, going through Udemy course after Udemy course or tutorial after tutorial, and never finishing anything or losing interest. I think this is because the game doesn't go in the direction I think it should go, or because it only ever covers the basics of game dev. These courses and tutorials leave no room for true development because you have no opportunity to design your game as your own. If you do anything different from the course and you stray off a little bit, it's really hard to get back on track with the course. Diverting from the course is only possible if you have some foundation and knowledge of game development. And the best way to get this knowledge is to start developing. Come up with an idea and start creating it. When you run into an issue that you don't know what to do, just look up a solution. There's a solution for everything out there. Then continue on creating your own way. So why is this important? Game dev doesn't need to be perfect. They just need to work. The player doesn't care what is going on behind the scenes as long as the game works. So this won't be your dream game, but it should be a game you would actually enjoy to play. Don't try to reinvent the wheel. All games are variants of a game that already exists, just with a little twist. When coming up with your game concept, base it off games you enjoy and that are successful, but also keep it simple. I wouldn't try to create the next Call of Duty or Halo franchise, but that doesn't mean you should stay away from FPSs. I've personally learned and retained more knowledge developing my own game than any course I've ever gone through. I think the reason for this is because I kept going back to the tutorial and copying exactly what they told me without thinking of why I was doing it. So like I said before, this doesn't have to be a Steam game. I would recommend just picking a game that exists and recreating it yourself. Go through the struggles and take your time. Before we get to the next point, you should go wishlist my game on Steam, Edenbound. Thanks. So put your game in a repository. This is so important, and I don't think I've ever seen it covered in a tutorial online. If you don't know what a repository is, or a repo for short, it's basically a place to store your project that has version control. So why is this extremely important? If you break your game and you don't have a way to fix it, you can easily go back to the last version and everything's all good. I don't know how many times I've had to go back to a different version of my project because of some assets I've imported which created bugs, or some updates and created some bugs that I couldn't figure out how to fix. So the easiest solution was to go back to a different version and not update those specific assets. So point number four is use third-party assets. Whether you're using Unity or Unreal, utilize the asset stores. There's no shame in using these assets. They were made for you to use them. Game development and 3D asset creation are completely different things. You're one person. You can't be good at everything. If developing your game is your goal, then use pre-made assets to start. You can even use them in your published games. You'll hear people say it's the worst thing in the world to do that, and that you're just asset flipping. Don't listen to them. Taking assets from the store and doing minimal work and selling it as a game is a very bad practice, but that doesn't mean you should stay away from them. For example, taking some trees and throwing a new shader to completely change the look of the tree is perfectly fine. As you continue on your development journey, you'll learn new ways to alter the assets and make them more unique for your game. If you are using 2D assets, well, these are a little easier to create on your own compared to 3D, so you could go down that route. The next point is stay away from environment design at the beginning. So environment design can be another trap. I've found myself in this many times. I've worked on color theory for weeks, which it's important for a game you are trying to release, but not as important when starting out. I would recommend using basic shapes and not giving anything textures unless absolutely needed. Focus on the game's functionality first. I did this for my 24-hour horror game challenge. I created a basic layout of what the scene would look like, but I didn't polish or really work on the environment until the very last thing. Now, throwing some trees into a level and adjusting the lighting and adding post-processing can be extremely satisfying, but it's kind of a black hole when you start. You can get lost in it. But that kind of leads me to my next point. Number 6, switching up what you're working on. I know I just said not to focus on environment, at least from the start, but I think it can be a morale booster if you do when you start getting burnout. Even throwing post-processing and nothing else on the scene can make a huge difference in how you feel. You will have burnout, and it does feel good to have a character walking through a nice scenic area. So number 7, and my most important point, I think, is stick with it and manage your time. And dedicate at least 1 hour a day every day to game dev. 30 minutes is just not enough, and 1 hour a day is better for retention than cramming 6 hours over the weekend. Do 1 hour a day every single day for a month, and you'll be surprised at how much you've learned. Do that every day for a year, and you'll be able to do things you never thought you could do without having to look things up. So that's all I have for now. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, please like and subscribe. Thanks.